Hi everyone, welcome to S4 Science. Today's our topic is animal tissues, class 9. We know that animal body is a complex structure. There are different parts is there which is doing different functions. That means there are different cells which is having different functions are there. All these functions carrying out by different tissue system, and we have divided the all tissue system into different categories. Actually, if you're dividing the animal tissue, you can divide into epithelial tissue and muscular tissue, nervous tissue and connective tissue. There are four different types of tissues. Again, there are minute classification is still there, but still we can divide the entire tissues into these four categories. Here in this picture, you can see here, there are epithelial tissue, which is the lining of their outer layer, skin and all other organs, you can see that. And you can see the muscles, right? The muscular tissues are there, which is the skeletal muscle, which is associated with the muscles, our voluntary action muscles. And there are involuntary actions in our body, like digestion and all, which is not in our control. There will be involuntary muscles, that are smooth muscles here. And the cardiac, right, throughout that life, it will be continuously beating and all. There are cardiac muscles are there in our brain and all other nerves part. There will be nervous tissues will be there. And all these things must be connected by some other tissue, which is called the connective tissue. We will go one by one in detail. Here, this is the overview of that animal tissues. You can see that animal tissue is divided into four different parts mainly. Epithelial tissue, muscular tissue, connective tissue and nervous tissue. Epithelial tissue, which is the covering tissue. Right? Here you can see that this is the epithelial tissue, which is a flat single layer tissue, which is like in plants, epidermis is the same way. Here in our animal body, there is an epithelial tissue, which is actually acting as a covering, right? And there will be connective tissue, which is providing the support, that means connection between all these tissue. You can see that there are different type of connective tissue that also we will do, right? You can see here, connective tissue, blood, lymph, bone, cartilage, all these things are included in the connective tissue. Each and everyone we will go in detail. The third one, that is a muscular tissue. Again, muscles also divide into three main categories. One is the voluntary muscles or striated muscles. That means wherever our will is happening, right? That means we can move the hands according to our will, according to our control. It's under control. So that's called voluntary muscles, right? So there the muscles are actually voluntary. They are striated muscles. Now there are some smooth muscles or involuntary muscles. Like they were. Where that involuntary actions are happening, like in digestion. When you are taking food, automatically the digestion will occur, right? It's not in our control. Lungs area, wherever it is, you can see that will breathe continuously. If we are, it's not in our control, right? So that's called involuntary muscles or the smooth muscles. In the other one is that cardiac muscle. Throughout the life, that means whether from the birth to death, they will continuously beating, right? They will continuously working. Such type of muscles are included in the cardiac muscles, right? So these are the three different types of muscular tissue. And the last one, that is the nervous tissue, which is actually coordinating or controlling all this tissue system. They are called the nervous tissue system or the nervous system. And the tissues present in that the nervous tissue and the cell nervous cells, nerve cells, right? Or the neurons, right? So these are the four different types of tissues in animals and their function slightly overview we have gone through that. First, we will discuss about the epithelial tissue. Then we will go for the next. So this session, we are mainly carrying out for epithelial tissue, right? So here, they are protective tissue, right? Of the human body. Like I told you, like epidermis in plants, the same way epithelial tissue is there, which is covering the entire human body, right? Human or any other animal, right? And it's also acting as a covering for the different organ. That means one organ is separated from the other organ. So that's actually by the epithelial cavity, that one covering will be there. Or in some organ, you can see that some cavity will be there, such as buccal cavity, right? Or even the digestive system inside the cavity will be there. Wherever the cavities are there, these cavities are also protected by the lining of epithelial tissue. So they cover mainly organs, many organs they will cover, right? And the cavities that are present inside the bodies also. Covering means it will like you can easily imagine. If you are in a refrigerator, if you are keeping different vegetables, right? So all together, if you are keeping, that will be a mess, right? So what we do, if you are having a brinjal, that you will keep in a special thin plastic cover, right? If you are having lady's finger, you will keep in another one. So like that, you will keep all these things, right? So that's why there is a separation. You can easily understand that there will be a separation, but all together, okay. Like the same way in our body, different organs are there, which is having a special covering. That's the epithelial tissue, right? And it will be separated from the other. Inside the cavity also, which is actually covering by the epithelial tissue. So what are the main, where you can find it, right? And what is the main function of that? The epithelial tissue found in the lining of blood vessels. I told you, wherever the lining is there, right? Differentiation is there. There you can see that lining of mouth, that is the buccal cavity, right? Where the kidney tubules are, the fine tubes are there, right? Even skin, you can see that epithelial tissue is there. Lung alveoli, which is very fine in nature, there also you can see that. So wherever in our, simply we can say that epithelial tissue is all over our body, and mainly it is covering so many organs and also their cavities. That's a simple thing we can say. Now, according to the structure and function, we are telling, according to the structure, different functions they are doing, right? Generally, we will go for the function, then we will go for each type of epithelial tissue. Here you told that it is acting as a covering, right? Obviously, they will be acting as a barrier, right? So, act as a barrier and separate different organs and system from each other. I told you, it will separate each other, right? So, it will act as a barrier. There will be no, that I want to say, separate connection, they separate protection they are providing, right? And here you can see that there will be no space in between the cell. It is a continuous layer. So, that's why I am telling it can compare with the epidermis in plants. It's also a continuous layer. But it's actually, these cells are really permeable and it will decide, right, with the exchange of materials, right? So, it is possible, right, for them to exchange the material between different parts of the body and also between the external environment. Different parts of the body and also between the external environment. External environment in the sense skin, right? So, it's actually permeable, right? It will decide the exchange of the material from outside to inward. And also inside, you can see the different body organs also the same way you can see. Right, the epithelial tissue actually it will remain separated from the tissue beneath their membrane. That means if it is a epithelial membrane, there is other, right, muscular membrane is there, muscle structure is there, or some fat tissues are there, whatever it is. So here it will be separate. This epithelial membrane will be separated from there. There will be another membrane which is called the basement membrane. Right. So this is the first layer. This is the epithelial membrane. Below that there will be a basement membrane, which is actually keep them separate from the other tissue layers. That means here in our hands, or if we are taking this example, that below this there will be fat tissue layer will be there. After that there will be muscular tissue will be there. Skeleton will be there. So all these actually separated from this epithelium by a basement membrane. Clear? Right. So according to the structure and all, this is divided into different types. Here you can see that, right? So, symbol, right? Symbol made up of single layer. That's actually the epithelium. Flat, single layered epithelium, which is called squamous epithelium or symbol squamous epithelium. If it is having different layer, then we will name it as stratified squamous, right? And if it is in cube shape, then we will name it as cuboidal epithelium. If it is a pillar-like shape, then it will name it as columnar epithelium, right? If it is having glands present in between, right, then it will be glandular epithelium. If it is having cilia present in them, then it will be ciliated epithelium. One by one we will go, right? I hope you have an idea about the picture. Here you can see the squamous epithelium, which is flat, which is mostly seen in our buccal cavity, right? If you are taking a toothpick, right, and if you are taking that thin, that now what to say, sample of that cheek cell, right, if you are spreading in a slide and if you are staining and observing microscope, you can easily see that the within flat layer of simple squamous epithelium will be there, right? And here you can see that there will be basement layer. This blue color layer is the basement membrane, which is actually separating from the other tissue, from the epithelium, right? Here also you can see that this is cuboidal, cube shape epithelial cells. Here also basement membrane, you can see that. This is columna, which is the pillar shaped cells, right? Here also you can see the epithelial cells. If this columnar layer having cilia, then it will become ciliated columnar. If it is having glands, then it will be glandular, right? And these squamous, if it is having so many layers in them, then it will be stratified squamous, which is just like in our skin. One by one we are going. So this is the overview of that table so that you can understand all these things. Here I have given the structure of different epithelium, right? And where it is, that now you can find it, right, That's actually the symbol squamous. The structure, they have very delicate, right? Cell lining and process a flat, thin structure we need, right? And it will be mostly common in alveoli and Bowman's scapula of nephron and all. That's actually in the kidney tubule. Then only you will understand. Stratified, then there will be more layers of that squamous, mostly in skin. Columnar, I told you, which is a pillar-like shape, that my epithelium, then it will be columnar. Mostly in intestine, you can see that. If cilia present in columnar, then it will be ciliated columnar. If that is in cube shape, then it will be cuboidal. If glands are present in the columnar and cuboidal, then it will be glandular. We will discuss the staple afterwards, once we will finish the entire discussion, right? First one is symbol squamous, right? Symbol squamous is actually a symbol in the mouth, in the mouth lining. You can see that the buccal cavity, we have given the example. It is actually in the lining of blood vessels, even lung alveoli, right? Inside the lungs, you can see that. Wherever the transportation substance is occurring, that means it is acting as a barrier, right? It is selectively permeable in nature. Wherever the transportation occurring, then it will be acting as a barrier. It will decide how much substance have to go in and out. That's actually, they are selectively permeable nature. And their mostly transport is through the diffusion. That means they facilitate that transport of substance through the diffusion. It helps for the diffusion of the substance very easy, right? And we discussed that it's very simple, flat and extremely thin kind of epithelium, right? And here you can see that it is in the mouth lining, that's the buccal cavity, you can see that. Esophagus, a food pipe lining, you can see. Lungs, alveoli, you can see that, right? And different part, even blood vessels everywhere. As a lining, you can see this type of epithelium, which is called symbol squamous layer. It's a very thin and a flat or single layer epithelium, right? And mainly function, I told you, it is helping for the transportation. And these are actually helping for that. The underlying part, right, from injury and entry of germs. So, it is somewhat providing protection also. Now, the second type of epithelium is stratified epithelium, right? Stratified squamous epithelium. It's a simple example, easy example, it's the skin, right? So, here the symbol squamous epithelium itself, but there will be more layer of symbol squamous. In symbol squamous, we told that there is single layer is there, right? So, single layer, only thin flat layer. Here, there are so many thin flat layers there. That means very much harder. Many layers will be present in that. Why it is actually, you know that whenever we are bathing or any other, the single dead cells will be removed from our skin. This only single layer, you just imagine. The next day, you can see that it's skeletal tissue. Is that possible? No, it's not. So, that's why striated squamous is actually helping from wear and tear. That's the main function of that, wear and tear. There will be any problems, injuries and all. So this is actually that helping for that wear and tear, right? So here you can see that skin epithelium are arranged in many layers to prevent wear and tear. That is called the stratified squamous epithelium. So here you can see that they are arranged in pattern of layer. This epithelium is called a stratified squamous, right? There are different stratified squamous, layers are there, pattern are there, right? So that's why it is called a stratified squamous. Main example is the skin, right? I hope you understand the concept here. The third type of epithelial tissue, that's a columnar epithelium. Columnar, you just make the symbol squamous into a pillar shape, right? Or the cylindrical shape. Then the name is columnar epithelium. Right, which is tall, cylindrical or pillar shaped epithelium, right? And here you can see that mostly their nucleus is at towards the base, right? Simple, thin hair, right? Stratified, they have some layers are columnar, we make it cylindrical or pillar shaped, and the nucleus mostly at the basal side, you can see that, right? And what is the function of this? Mainly it is absorptive in their function. And you can see that wherever absorption and secretion is there, that means inside the stomach or even intestine, right, in some goblet cells, which is mucus secreting, that cells are the goblet cell, all these areas, wherever absorption secretion is there, you can see the columnar epithelium will be there, right? And mostly it is found in the inner lining of stomach and intestine, right? There are some other also, but at least some example we have to learn. Now the next category, that's the ciliated epithelium. If you understand this order, it's very easy to understand, right? So here the columnar epithelium. Now it is the pillar shaped or cylindrical shape. Just give some cilia on that, right? Cilia are fine hair-like structures, right? If you are giving that fine hair-like structure, then it will help for the EC movement, right? These cilia all together, they will move together. That type of epithelial tissue is called ciliated columnar epithelium or ciliated epithelium in simple, right? So, columnar epithelium having cilia for their movement of substance are called ciliated epithelium, right? Here, that mostly present in that respiratory tract or even sperm, that what we say, oviduct, ovum, right? And oviduct, maybe you haven't learned that, reproductive system. And there also you can see the ciliated epithelium in there because of the movement of the ovum, right? Simple example I will give that you can understand. Sometimes you can see that the mucus will be there, right? Why the mucus is there in the nasal tract? Because it's actually capturing the dust particle or any other germs or anything coming here, that will be captured there. Inside the tracheal lining also you can see that mucus particle will be there. The mucus that has to go out if any germs or anything captured there, that has to be pulled out so that it has to be excreted out, ejected out. That's the main thing, right? So for the excretion, it will be this germ that mucus will be pulled out by the ciliated epithelium through the respiratory tract. You can see that in their respiratory tract, there will be ciliated epithelium. So they will move together, that means move upward, right? This mucus is present, it will move upward the mucus, right? And it will be pushed outward by the action of the ciliated epithelium. So you can see that the respiratory tract, right? The mucus is pushed outward or upward by the ciliated cells and clear the entire tract. Now, the next type of epithelium, which is the glandular epithelium. So what we have done, the columnar epithelium itself, we made some glands, that means some inner foldings are there in some columnar epithelium. Even cuboidal epithelium also having glands, right? That's actually inner folding. Inner folding hai, so that means the surface area increases. If the surface area increases, right, so there will be so many area of action, absorption or secretion, surface increases. These glands having special capacity to secrete some chemicals, right, into their surface. That columnar epithelium having glands in them, they are called the glandular epithelium. Where can you find this? Wherever the glands are there, wherever the secretion occurs, you can find this type of epithelium, right? So columnar epithelium modified to form the glands in them are called the glandular columnar epithelium or glandular epithelium, right? Some portion of this epithelium fold inward to form the epithelial gland, and this will secrete some chemicals into the epithelial surface. Where can you find? In tear glands. Tear glands, right? Liver, which is the largest gland, pancreas, wherever the glands are there, which is secretive in function, you can see this type of glandular epithelium in them. The last type of epithelium, which is the cuboidal epithelium. So again, the pillar ko, right? We just press now from all sides, it will become a cube. Then the name is cuboidal epithelium. I told you, if you remember the order, symbol, squamous, a single layer, multi-layer, then stratified, right? We just become to pillar shape, then columnar, right? Columnar having cilia, ciliated columnar. Columnar having glands, glandular. Then if you are pressing down and making it a cube, that is cuboidal. So you can easily remember that. Don't by heart anything, just understand and you just recreate that. Then it will be very easy to learn, right? Cuboidal epithelium, as the name suggests, it is cube shaped, right? It can be glandular also. I told you glandular, cuboidal epithelium can also have glands, then it will be glandular, right? And main function is that it is also absorption. If gland present, obviously secretion will be there, and also excretion of material also, it is, for that also it is helping, right? And it's cuboidal, you can see the cube, that means strengthened, right? It can be seen in that blood vessels and all the cube, kidney tubule, all over, you can see that in the round way. So that means cube like that, it will be arranged like that, which will give that mechanical support for the tube. You can see that it is a blood vessel or area, you can see that the cuboidal epithelium, which will give that mechanical support, right? It will prevent the collapsing of the blood vessel, kidney tubule and all, right? So that's why it is providing mechanical support also. Where can you find? Fountain salivary glands, lining of kidney tubule and blood vessels, etc. I hope you have a clear idea of epithelial tissues and their types and their function. Once again, we will go for that, this one. You can see here, symbol, right, which is made up of single layer, stratified, then there will be multi-layer. Cube shape, then it is cuboidal, right, symbol cuboidal, you can see that. And if it is, column cylindrical shape, then it will be columnar, right. And here you can see that stratified squamous, there will be multi-layer itself, right. And here the glands are present and glandular, and these all are the different types of epithelium. Here once again we will go for the entire chart also. Umbilical squamous, then stratified dermal layer in skin and all, right? Columna, that called the cylindrical shape, which is in the intestine, absorption and secretion, which is having cilia, which is mostly in respiratory tract. Cuboidal, the cube shape, absorption, secretion, excretion, etc., and also provide mechanical support in kidney tubule, right? And the glandula, I told you, wherever the glands are, the secretion, the sweat glands, salivary glands, or even tear glands, right? Which is that secretion, the function. These are the entire idea of the different types of epithelium. I hope you have an idea. Thank you.